Hello friends, welcome to my little humble abode. Just like myself, have you ever wondered to yourself, what the hell is that? Or, what are those? Well guess what, just like these scientists in this video today, we're gonna figure out what the hell those things are. Join me, thank you.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Micah, this is Winston. And as always, we're just going to get started right into this. This is new for me. This is Ridddle with 3Ds. This is insane abilities of extinct animals you didn't know about. So without further ado, we're just going to dive right into this. Let's go.
Who do you think it is? A horse, a gorilla, or a zebra? It's all of that combined. This is the Calicotherium, and it lived in territories of Eurasia and Africa in the Miocene epoch, the period when evolution created the most bizarre and surrealistic creatures. Thanks to such an unusual physique, this animal needed just one powerful right hook to knock any predator out.
Well, that was mainly thanks to, you know, the abundance of oxygen at the time, too. And with all the huge amounts of freaking green, that was, you know what I'm saying, like actual foliage and stuff like that, that was going on, like, because if I'm not mistaken, Antarctica was even green at this point, so the whole world was just on overdrive with that stuff. And if I'm not mistaken, whenever you have like an abundance of one or two things. Whenever you have an abundance of oxygen or like an unbrighted like room to grow, you're pretty much gonna get like these huge giant monsters like that. Because that's how it is in like the ocean, if I'm not mistaken. Not the oxygen thing, but the fact that they're unbridled to grow. Like they don't have anything stopping them from growing. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's one thing. And then
if I'm not mistaken, with them, yeah, it was just the oxygen. But yeah, I feel like I'm talking on my ass right now. Let's keep going.
And that's not the only oddball with a unique superpower that existed long before us. In this video, I'll tell you what creature could break the sound barrier, who had a vacuum cleaner kind of mouth, who could move upside down, and most importantly, what were the most extraordinary features that extinct animals had? Spoiler alert, one of these creatures I've just made up. Can you guess which one? Some remains of prehistoric animals are so unusual that they provoke fierce controversies among paleontologists. For instance, hallucigenia that lived in Canada and China more than 500 million years ago. Meet the beauty. No, wait, this way. Or maybe, well, even scientists took their time to figure out where its front, back, lower, and upper parts are. The thing is, scholars...
And even then, that could just be a skeletal system that for all we know, you know what I'm saying? And they actually, for all we know, they could have actually had a head, but their head was, you know what I'm saying, made of soft tissue. So it dissolved throughout time. So, and all of their heads dissolved throughout time. So whenever their, their fossils came up, it just looked like that. You know what I'm saying? Like that's actually a really big problem when it comes to paleontology. It's the fact that, especially with Earth creatures, like 90% of Earth animals have, even today, have soft, squishy parts. You know what I'm saying? And or their bones match nowhere near their freaking like outer exterior. You know what I'm saying? So, that's just one of those things.
Mistook its feet for tentacles growing on the body. Well, they thought that the back spikes were its feet. Apart from the skill of tricking scientists, this invertebrate presumably had a sophisticated set of teeth. Yeah, this mouth doesn't belong to Demogorgon from Stranger Things. It belongs to Hallucigenia. The creature had needle-shaped teeth, not only in its mouth, but also in its throat, so that it could suck up and grind food. But to give you a chance to sleep peacefully tonight, let me clarify one thing. This beast was no bigger than a pinky and couldn't harm you in any way. Now, the Rack Scientific Brains Challenge is accepted by Opabinia regalis that was the size of a piece of chalk. It lived in present-day Colombia and Canada around 500 million years ago. And again, scientists couldn't tell what was in this creature right away. It turned out that it swam upside down, and its five eyes were located on the back of its head. What's more, researchers were confused by the tail of the Diplodocus that lived in Colorado. What is this? A whip for prehistoric horseback riding? The tail was 14 meters long, which is approximately 7 Michael Jordans. Scientists suggest that Diplodocus could even break the sound barrier when swinging its tail back and forth at high speed. This supersonic punch helped the animal protect itself from predator attacks. Quite a convenient self-defense method, right? There were also creatures with specific features that their modern descendants would gladly inherit. At first glance, Onalashka stylus Tomadai from the Aleutian Islands is a regular hippopotamus of our era. So what's so special about it? Its mouth. The modern animal that descended from this genus also has quite a terrifying muzzle. But that ancient beast could pull its jaws together and suck plants up while easing the whole process with its powerful muscles. In other words, that was a prehistoric hippopotamus that had a vacuum cleaner instead of a mouth. Modern snakes could also improve their technique of food consumption. But for that, they'd need feet like those that Tetrapodophis amplectus from Brazil used to have. It lived 110 million years ago, and its feet were very tiny, just 1 centimeter long, roughly the size of a regular paperclip. They helped the snake better grab its prey, for example, small birds. In their turn, feathered animals defended themselves from predators of that kind using maces on their wings. Or at least something like this was...
I'm guessing now the reason why evolution got rid of that is just the fact that coiling onto a predator or onto its prey is way more effective than those little vestigial little arms which seems like, you know, trying to pad its way into it. Definitely seems like not the best thing to have, definitely.
Or at least something like this was found on the body of the Rodriguez solitaire from the island of Rodriguez. This bird is a relative of the dodo that went extinct in the 18th century. It also was flightless and was the size of a goose. Rounded, thick cartilages that looked like maces were located on its wings and helped it defend itself. Although they were no bigger than a human belly button, those spheres let the birds break their attackers' bones. However, some prehistoric animals were born with specific characteristics that were rather more troublesome than helpful. What could be a nuisance of that sort? For example, one dinosaur species was unfortunate enough to have short hands. But I'm not talking about the Tyrannosaurus. I mean the Carnotaurus that occupied territories of modern Argentina. T-Rex's forelimbs were quite strong, letting them hold on to their opponent while fighting with it. As for the Carnotaurus, its hands were no longer than that of a 10-year-old child. They couldn't be used anyhow at all. It's still unclear why evolution was so cruel to Carnotaurus. If it lived nowadays, a Carnotaurus could at least ride a bike and shout,
"Look, Mom, go ahead!"
Now, this Mexican gopher called Ceratogallus had a complete set of proper limbs and even a small bonus on top of that. And that's the horns. You may think it used them for digging, but no. The horns were placed at an angle that made them barely suitable for such tasks. Most likely, everything they did caused a migraine, and that's why modern gophers have given up this uncomfortable headwear. And now, I want you to take a long, hard look at Dreadnoughtus. It was the most giant terrestrial animal that has ever existed, and it lived in Argentina 86 million years ago. This dinosaur was 26 meters tall. That's a bit shorter than two Hollywood signs placed on top of each other. Dreadnoughtus weighed 65,000 kilograms, and that's more than 7 Tyrannosauruses. Try to guess what kind
of... They're such weird, weird measurement things of measurements. Like, I'm not really 100% sure how big the Hollywood sign is, but I'm guessing it's super big. But yeah.
Try to guess what kind of problems a cool guy like this could have. It was so huge that finding enough food to feed oneself was pretty challenging. Being just the most enormous fellow won't do. You have to be the most...
And I feel like that even is just an assumption. Us feeling like they had a hard time finding food, like, really know that, like, other than, like, there's nothing, I feel like there's nothing really for us to know, like, to tell that, because we, other than, like, us having a pretty good knowledge of the, what the plant life was like around him, but if that's the case, don't you think that they would migrate or something, you know what I'm saying, or, I don't know, but I feel like, you know, plant fossils are a little bit more harder to come by than other fossils. I know there's still a whole bunch of them out there, but I feel like they're a little bit more harder to come by than normal fossils, but yeah.
Ferocious one, like these thugs. When it comes to the strongest extinct animals, the first beast that comes to mind is the Tyrannosaurus we've talked about a lot today. And we've already shattered the myth that this dinosaur from North America had the shortest hands. Let's move to the theory that the Tyrannosaurus could only see moving objects. That's a total lie, too. Actually, T-Rexes had one of the best eyesight of all the animals. Today, we think that the sharpest eyes belong to eagles, since they can see things 3.6 times better than humans. At the same time, the eyesight of T-Rexes was no less than 13 times better than ours. We can sight objects located 1.6 kilometers away. But a T-Rex could easily see them even if they were 6 kilometers away. In fact, it could take a tour of Hillwood Estate.
Look out some window and watch what they're doing there at the White House.
But even having a keen vision like that, this dinosaur wouldn't spot Enigma broma, a prehistoric giant octopus that could be found in the Pacific Ocean. Just like its descendants, it could skillfully disguise itself. Besides, it had small lumps on the head that resembled horns. It's doubtful that it used them as means of defense. The worst they could do was tickling sharks' stomachs. Maybe the horns helped the octopus flip rocks while searching for fish. The most exciting part is that Enigma broma could be a relative of the animal you've already been introduced to, Hallucigenia. Their teeth look very similar, several rows of sharp needles. But this time, I'm afraid I can't put you at ease, because unlike little harmless Hallucigenia, Enigma broma was 11 meters long. That's like 2.7 giraffes. You'll see him in your next nightmare. All right, no need to freak out. In this prehistoric gang, there was a giant that could beat the undersea venom. And that is Mosasaurus, a mighty predator who lived in the waters of Europe and...
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, that was, I think, known as one of, if not the biggest dinosaur to ever live. But like I said, it's just one of those things where if you're in the ocean, you're already, like, we already have, like, some of the biggest animals in the ocean. Obviously, whales, lion mane, jellyfish, all these types of huge freaking, marine life. And then you go back millions of years where everything on land was already massive. In the ocean, they're probably looking like freaking a Burj Khalifa swimming in the fucking ocean. Like, just enormous size things swimming. Scary thinking.
North America, 70 million years ago. Its length could reach up to 17 meters, which is approximately 2 London buses. In fact, that was the most dangerous creature of the ocean throughout the whole Cretaceous period. It looked like a giant crocodile with fins that helped it move under the water. In this case, it won't be shameful to say, thank God it went extinct. Well, I think it's time to figure out which of these ancient animals with odd features is nothing more than a figment of my imagination. The horned gopher, the bird with maces, or maybe the giant dinosaur that...
Honestly, I would say it's most likely the octopus because, octopuses don't really have too much to, fossilize. Pretty sure.
It could crush any of the letters of the Hollywood sign in one move of its foot. Any other suggestions? Share your ideas in the comments.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, just because, I've never seen that in my life, and all the other ones I've actually seen before, to be honest with you, but that one's like the only one that I didn't see. Not to mention, that was the only one that I didn't really see a fossil with, to be that he showed along with it. But in case, though, thank you guys again for joining me on another episode of Micah's Intellectual Corner. If you guys like this episode, then we'll definitely do a lot more Ridddle in the future. Say peace out to Winston. I'll see you guys on the next one.